Hi Grover, Chris here from mtbtips.com. Ever been for a muddy ride and washed your bike afterwards, only to find that the next time you go for a ride, your disc brakes have lost a lot of their performance? Well, often that loss in performance can be caused from a film of mud that's still on your brake pads. It's been squeezed into the surface of the pad material during that previously muddy ride, and that's what drops the performance of your brakes. Now, sure, the rotors will eventually clean themselves, and performance will be restored, but sometimes that can take the first 20 to 30 minutes of your ride. And particularly if the next ride you go on is a race, you want to make sure that your brakes work 100% straight out of the blocks. You don't want to be waiting the first 20 minutes or first 10 kilometers until your brakes get that positive feel back. Now, there are plenty of disc brake cleaner products out there from brands the likes of Muckoff and Finish Line and others that do a really good job of cleaning your brakes and restoring the brake performance. And particularly if you've got greasy or oily deposits on your rotors and your pads, then they're the products you need. And rubbing alcohol and methylated spirits work well too, just don't set yourself on fire. But 9 times out of 10, the only thing that you'll have on your brakes is mud and dirt and dust. And so you don't really need anything fancy. And if your mountain biking budget is pretty tight like mine, then you don't have the luxury of going out and buying the latest $10 or $20 product to hit the shelves to keep your bike in good repair. So let's do it the easy way. All you'll need is a scrubbing brush, some cloth, some rag, a bit of sandpaper, and the tools required to remove your disc brake pads. As well as that, you'll need some water, and you know, the kitchen scourer, this is a non-scratch one, might come in handy, as to a flat blade screwdriver if you don't have one on your mountain bike multi-tool. So let's get to it. I've actually done the first 2 steps already. I've removed my rear wheel and I've removed my rear disc brake pads and the pad spring. Let's go to step number 3. Now, if you have a look closely there, you'll see that the disc brake pads are just covered in mud, and there's a surface, there's a layer of mud on the surface there. So we're just going to give that a good clean. What I'll do is I'll scrub around the pad with a scrubbing brush. I'll scrub on the back too to make sure that's nice and flat and smooth there where the piston pushes down on the brake pad. And I'll use my screwdriver as well, just to get around the edges there to make sure all of that mud's off, to make sure that the pad spring has somewhere nice and flat to sit around the square edges of the pad there. Then after that, I'll give her a wipe. If I need to, I'll use a bit of water just to help remove that mud. So I'll get to it now. Almost perfect, but what we'll do is we'll grab the sandpaper, make sure it's on something flat, and press down evenly onto the back of the pad and just rub it back and forth a bit just to restore that pad material to perfect there. There's still a little bit of a trace of mud on it. Now, as you can see, between those 2 pads, the one on the left is the one I've cleaned and the one on the right is the one that's still dirty. So there's a big difference there, and that is going to make a big difference to your braking performance. Now all you need to do is clean the other pad and then clean the pad spring. Pad spring, it doesn't look too bad, but it's got a bit of mud on it, so I'll just give it a good wipe. And that ensures as well that it sits nice and flat where it's supposed to, around those pad blocks. Okay, now onto the brake caliper, and I've got myself a thin piece of cloth here. It's a bit of old towel, it's nice and fluffy, which is good, and I've just dampened it with a bit of water, and I'm just going to pass it through the caliper here, back and forth several times like that, just to clean inside the caliper, and I'll make sure I clean on the faces of the piston there, once again to make sure that those pistons are nice and flat and clean, and they push squarely on the back of the brake pads. So that's all done there, nice and clean inside. Now, remember, when you are cleaning your brake system, make sure that you don't direct any high pressure water or air into the brake calipers, because you could risk blowing dirt and dust in past the piston seals and into your brake system, and then your brakes will eventually start leaking, and nobody likes leaky brakes. Okay, now what you'll want to do is give your rotor a good clean on both sides with scrubbing brush and then give it a wipe. How easy is this? You're almost done. All you need to do now is reinstall both clean brake pads and don't forget the pad spring, and then put your rear wheel back in, then go and do the front disc brakes and you're finished. Simple as that. And hey, here's a super tip. Make sure that when your wheels are out, you don't apply those brake levers. Otherwise, more than likely, you'll reset the brake pistons closer together and you won't be able to sneak the rotor back in between the brake pads. But if that does happen, don't worry. All you need to do is make sure your wheel is out, have those brake pads in place, and with a large flat blade screwdriver in between the pads, just ever so gently lever those pads apart to push those pistons back out so that you can get the rotor back in. And then when you go for your first ride, a few applications of the lever will automatically reset the pistons in the right position. And hey, for a few more super tips that aren't in this video that will really help you keep your disc brakes in top working order, please go to the website, check out the quick and easy disc brake clean. It's all there for you. And hey, remember, all of these little super tips here and there, they really do add up to giving you a much richer, much more enjoyable mountain bike experience every time you ride. I really do hope this tip helps you with your mountain biking. Enjoy.